and cent percent, how many are there? Between 80 and 90, how many are there? Like if you group the students, what is that will have? So that means this is the exact raw data given to you, but the next level is I just segregate the data. So out of 10,000, you will have around 300 records between 90 to cent percent. And again, 80 to 90%, you have got another 600 records, let us suppose. Then between 60 and 70, you have got some other set line. Okay. And the maximum number of people, so suppose if you look at the graph of that, it might, this is the majority of population. This is a curve like this. You know about the normal distribution curve, right? So if you look at people with 92 cent percent will be very few in this structure. And similarly, the people failed also will be very less in this curve, right? The people who got 60% will be maximum. Normally class low you observe, right? Majority, everyone will get first class almost, the entire section. So this is the kind of distribution you will have. So what you will do, first of all, you will classify the data or segregate the data. Then for visualization, you will draw a graph like this or a bar chart or a pie chart or whatever it is, right? From the data, after grouping that, you will make a diagram out of it. Then you can interpret the results. Yes, in my college, some 10% people scored more than 90%. They are good. In computer science, people are very good. They scored this much. Their placement is high. Like, you can visualize the stuff. So to visualize the stuff, what is that you have done? You have grouped the data, then you have got something at a higher level of abstraction. Higher level of abstraction means you are not talking about individual person. He got 90%, he got 92, she got 93. I am not saying that. I am saying around 10% are there within this range of 90 to 100. These many are there in specific range, like you are talking, then that gives a visualization for you to understand. So that is studying the things at higher level of granularity. Okay? There, the specifics will not matter. This is for analysis purpose. Please remember, in your online transaction processing system, you don't look at the higher level of abstraction or generalization. You look at individual transactions, individual information, right? So that is the difference between your online transaction aspects and analytical aspects. So the analytical aspects are more general, or it is statistics based stuff or grouping based stuff. It's not the exact figures you will have. Okay? It depends on the kind of interpretation. So here, then what is this multi-dimensional data cube? Just I will tell you, but about this data cubes and all we will study. But what it is, I will just tell you very, very briefly. Okay? I thought you need to have some basic idea about it. Multidimensional data cubing is one type of process used. It's not the only data mining technique or something used. It is one kind of technique. This is helpful if your data is numeric. Your data is numeric. So here, The concept behind this is an example. What is multidimensional here? What is dimension? What is data cube? Right? These are few things that prick your mind. Okay. Suppose you consider there is one company that is selling a lot of goods. Okay. So when you are selling the goods, see here, you want to have the sales analysis. There is a company, okay, it is selling different electronic goods and equipment in its stores. Okay. So it is selling computers, home entertainment things, phones, and security device equipment. These are the four categories of items. Please remember, the category is higher level of abstraction. If you go to the items, there you have individual items sold. Please remember, that's why I'm telling you. So it is selling four kinds of items there. And it is selling in the areas of Vancouver zone, Toronto, it's in Canada, New York, and Chicago. These are the four regions wherein the sales are happening. But they are not the only four things. They are the zones wherein the sale is happening. Now see here, if you look at the other dimension in the cube, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. What is that Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4? Quarters, first quarter. That means from January 1st to March 31st. Then April 1st to June 30th. Like this, the entire 12 months is divided into four quarters. So here, if you look at this cube, okay, see, in the cube some figures are there. That is 605. What is the meaning of that 605 is the total quantity sold in quarter one in the Vancouver area for home entertainment equipment. Are you able to get the idea? So that means it could be the quantity or it could be the number of items sold. Let us say it is the amount, let us suppose, amount sold. Okay. If it is the amount sold, maybe it is $605 million of sales took place in quarter one for home entertainment equipment in the Vancouver zone. That is the interpretation of it. But how do you get that kind of interpretation? If you look at it, I told you previously, you have the point of sale transaction. Point of sale transaction means that is the just bill you have, right? So that means if you look at the bill, what you will have? The bill will be, okay, they call this as All Electronics Company. It is Chicago. It's Vancouver means the Vancouver zone. But you will have lot of cities there. Okay. So similarly, Chicago means just that zone, not just Chicago state. Chicago city zone. Okay, it's Illinois state. Chicago means okay. So if you look at the bill, what is that you will have? Just if you look at the bill, store name, right? Then like this, item one, okay, entertainment, some wireless headphones. Something is some iPod. These are the components. Cost is some $20. This is some $50. Like you will have some amount and the total amount you will have, right? This is how the point of sale transaction bill will be, right? So you will get all these point of sale transaction bills as input, because how you will make the data cube means I'm telling. So that is the bill. So you will read all the bills. Then you will, so there each line is one entry for your data warehouse. So in your data warehouse, you will have the item code, the region in which it is sold, or the city in which it is sold. Then you will enter the quantity, the dollar amount paid. So that will be the elementary level of granularity record it is. That is the point of sale transaction. That is the most elementary level record you transform it into the data warehouse. Getting my point here? So this will be moved like this. So as and when the end transaction happens, when bill happens, okay, when transaction is finalized, these entries will be moved into that transactional file, and then from which you will build the data warehouse. But from the data warehouse, you have to build the data cube. So how do you build the data cube? That is, you know the city, right? As you know the city, you can get the region in which it is there. Okay. You know the date. So to which month it comes to, so or to which quarter it comes to, you can find out. So once this data is there, you will be performing the summarization aspects. How the summarization is done and all, I'll tell you in the third unit when it comes to exam. Okay. So it will be summarized like this. Now this data cube is built. Okay. So now what is the significance here? What you said, multi-dimensional data cube. What is this concept of multi-dimensional? Here, these are all the factors across which you analyze the sales. Because at the end of the day, what is needed for you? You want to find out which item or which category is sold better